Hi there, I'm going to show you how to bulk upload students onto your PM eCollection. Now that you're on the PM eCollection teacher's dashboard, on the left-hand side of the screen, you'll see six tabs: subscriptions, dashboard, students, group, sessions, and teachers. You'll need to click the student section, which will bring you to a list of all the students in your school. If you're new to the subscription and have not loaded any students, there will be no students available in this section. On the left-hand side of the screen, there'll be a blue button that says Create Student Profile. You'll need to click this. And there are three different ways in which you can upload a student to your subscription. A manual VIA form, which is a manual entry of one student per time. We're going to do this first. The other one is upload via spreadsheet and also search past students. So first we're going to do is manual via form, which is a manual upload of one student at one time. As you can see, the criteria will be first name, last name, date of birth, gender, age, year level, PM reading level. If they are in reading recovery, you can also select those options, a username and a password, as well as what levels the student is able to access on their bookshelf. The ones highlighted with an blue asterisk next to it need to be entered. Everything else is not mandatory. So we'll go ahead and enter a student's name here. As you can see down the bottom here, the username is self-generated by the system. This ensures that no double ups occur with the usernames. For the time being, I'm going to leave the students' available bookshelf levels as 1 to 30. And now we can add the student. As you can see, Theo was successfully added. In this session, we have added one student. What you'll now be able to do is click print. And that will provide you with a student card that you can print out for the student to have their username and password accessible at all times, even if they're using it from home. The next step is a bulk upload of multiple students at one time. And what you'll need to do is go back to the students page, click Create Student Profile, and we're going to upload via spreadsheet. Click Use and follow the instructions. It asks you to download this Excel spreadsheet, which we can click. As you can see, it's downloaded. And as you can see, this is the Excel spreadsheet now. So the columns include first name, last name, password, date of birth, gender, year level, username, PM reading level, reading recovery, ESL. A key over here will show you that blue fields are mandatory while the green fields are optional. So we'll go ahead and enter three students into this system. So what I'll need to key in is their first name, last name, password, and year level. Those ones are mandatory, whilst everything else will not be needed. As I previously said, usernames will be self-generated once the upload occurs, and each student will receive their own username based on the system. You will also notice that I placed the password the same for every student. This is an option that is available to be done, as it makes it easier if you do have a bulk upload and you'd like for all students to have the same password to avoid confusion. Again, we change the year levels. I haven't included any other details, like I said, because it is an option and this can be a time consuming process. And if you abstract the time, you're able to just input that in later and you can update their details later on. So I'm going to go ahead and save this file to my system. Now we're going to bulk upload this to the system. So what we need to do is find the file in the system. So we'll go to browse. We're going to click upload. So now if we type in Chris Smith, you can now see that Chris Smith has been added to the system. We can go in and edit his profile as well. And as I was saying, it self-generates everything of that person. So we can change their date of birth. And as you can see, the username has been self-generated. So that'll be their username. And you can also change this password when you feel necessary. So now we're in the student's profile and we're able to adjust a few things if need be. You can see up here, Chris Smith, that's his name. We have the option again for ESL and reading recovery. And we can change what reading level the student is at as they progress. Titles available on Chris's bookshelf. Again, we can move this scale to where we feel is necessary and how that student is progressing. So now, as an example, Chris will only be able to see levels 9 and 10 PM readers on his PME collection bookshelf. Again, I'm going to go ahead and open this up for the time being. It will also show you a history of the student's reading. As Chris is a new student, he currently has no books opened, has a reading age of 5 because he has just started. There have been no recordings made and no words have been saved to his word bank. There's also a tab down the bottom which will provide you with a reading history of the student and any particular groups or classrooms that student is available, a part of. This search button allows you to search for all students in the classroom, in the school that have a subscription. And it is a running search, so it'll pop up automatically, anybody with those spelling criteria. Again, another feature of this student section is that you're able to select the students who possibly have lost their student card and you can reprint those. So we can just click the students that you'd like to and we can bring those up and we can print them out for them to have again. Thank you.